it's our understanding that they were going somewhere at 99. As they were on Jennings Road, the defendant was traveling about anywhere between 96 and 113 miles an hour on Jennings Road, which is a dark and windy road, which your honor's probably familiar with it. And the speed limit in that area is 30 miles an hour. They approached the hill, which is on Jennings Road, and it's a steep decline. They went over that hill, and the defendant lost control of his vehicle. And he sheared off the bottom of the power pole, about almost 3 feet of it, and the power pole just kind of went back into the ground, but that whole section of power pole was found down the road. And then at that point, the vehicle started rolling over. The victim, of course, was in the passenger seat. He lost his arm previous to the car coming to a stationary position, and he died instantly of a head injury.
So here we have a fella, he's 35 years old, who's lived an honorable life. He lived an admirable life, loving parents, devoted parents, who makes an error of judgment in a moment of time, which now affects everyone negatively for the rest of their lives. And I hope that his lifetime of good works is not going to be wasted here. I just don't know what the future bodes for him in the penitentiary.
It's not in the brakes. All I can do is try to fix it. I've tried everything I could to fix as much as I could. I wish I died instead. The only reason I'm alive today is because of a pinky promise with my daughter. And that's why I sit here today. I don't want to go through this. I don't want to continue to go through this. I'm sorry. I never meant any bad intent against anybody, and I never will. That's it. I don't know what to say. I just can't speak. I'm sorry.